the accident that caused all this, I don't feel that any amount of training is going to change what happened. You know, the man had violations, that can help, but he ran a stop sign.
A logbook review has shown the driver at the center of the Humboldt crash shouldn't have even been on the road due to inconsistencies in miles logged and the brakes he'd taken. In Canada, the laws are that for every 13 hours you drive, you have to take a minimum of 10 hours off, 8 of which should be for sleep.
This shows me how many hours I've been off duty. I'm basically doing what we call a reset. I need 36 hours off, and that resets my total hours for the week, so I start over again with 70 hours. This graph would be the same as a paper log book or any electronic log. Basically, every green line shows, corresponds with on duty, off duty, sleeper berth, or driving time.
But drivers say with the current system, it's easier to fudge the numbers and make it look like you're taking the required breaks even if you aren't, so truck drivers can stay on the road longer.
So everyone run about the money, right? He wants to earn the more money, so every driver wants to be more mileage and more earnings.
Since Humboldt, the industry has sped up the process of implementing an electronic logging system in Canada, which makes cheating nearly impossible. It's already mandatory for all truckers driving in the U.S. and could be federally mandated here by 2020.
So it has a marking location of where they are, it has when they're driving, when they're moving, engine running, all that technology. So it does make it a lot more difficult to falsify your logbook, so we welcome that as an industry.
Drivers and the association say fixing the issue starts with ownership.
It's their motor carrier rights that we're running under. I mean, ultimately, the company I currently work for, if I tell them it's not fit for me to be on the road, whether it's weather or tired, sick, whatever, I don't get an argument. I know there's some companies out there that, oh, well, you know, you got to go.
But the big question is there anything that can be done to prevent another Humboldt?
I'm not sure if I can say this, but in my opinion, no amount of training can fix stupidity. And that's where we're at with the trucking industry.
In Calgary, Jonathan Muma, City News.